fucking knocking that.
And welcome to York St John's Roundup of Sport for the 10th of December 2014.
Well, as you can see, the Christmas break is almost with this lovely tree. Well done, the SU. And we've got a plethora of different sport teams coming in to do an interview with us today. It should be a lot of fun.
Yep.
And yeah, this is the Roundup. Welcome to YSJ Sport. So we'll start proceedings with the netball results.
So netball first continued their storming season with a win over UCLan of 59-47, putting them joint top of the league, just missing out on goal difference to Liverpool John Moores. So we've just had a quick look at the netball results for the year. So this is Amy Stevens, first team captain for YSJ Ladies Netball. Obviously ladies, we don't have a men's team. So Amy, how is the season going so far?
The season's going really well so far. We're sitting second in the table with a game in hand. The only reason is because we had a walkover against Edge Hill, so we didn't get any goals for that. But we beat them by 20 in the first game, so we should have a goal difference, but we don't.
Not fair. Not really fair.
So really, really good. Fantastic. Yeah. So as we all know, you're an Excel team. So how have you found being an Excel team? Do you think there's a lot of pressure on to win every game?
I don't think there's pressure. I think we expect to win because of what we put ourselves under, so we know we're good enough to win. But the Excel program's going really well. The strength and conditioning is really good. Attendance is good every week, and we're all enjoying it. So yeah,
fantastic.
It's good.
It's
funny,
isn't it? It's absolutely brilliant.
So on a more personal note, in terms of members of your club, who do you think has the most bizarre pre-match ritual, or brings a strange item to training or to matches?
Well, I bring my One Direction towel.
I knew it was you.
Nice.
Which member of One Direction are we like persuaded towards?
Well, I love them all, but I've got a big obsession with Harry Styles.
Fantastic. So in true Christmas style, we brought you a gift. There's two gifts, actually. One is the gift of a sticker. The other is the gift of being touched by Jack Bennett.
Wow.
So if you'd just like to indicate where you would like it in the rules of
shoe,
kind of like full disclosure, he has chosen your shoe.
Brilliant.
So yeah, that looks good there. Made that awkward. So a big thank you to Amy Stevens. We wish you all the best in
thank
the up and coming season. And have a nice Christmas and New Year.
Happy Christmas.
And here we are to Rugby League's results. And here is the Rugby League BUCS Northern 2B table. As you can see, they are doing very well at the top there with 15 points and have a fantastic goal difference as well.
Some pretty outstanding results there from Rugby League. So with us today, we have Sam Rowe, who is the vice-captain of Men's Rugby League. So Sam, how is the season going so far?
Very well, yeah. Coming on from last year, we've unbeaten us so far this season. Probably got our biggest result ever, winning 100-0 against Hull.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Also, we won the Crosscodes. Unlucky Jack. Yeah, but we're doing really well.
How's your freshers getting on?
Oh, brilliant. We've got some really good players coming this year. Got some good forwards, especially. Got young halfback as well, young Batty. He's coming really well. He's
added, we've seen nights, hasn't he?
Yeah. He's had a lot of damage to our play, so it's really good.
Fantastic. Sounds good.
Really, really good.
Yeah.
So, Sam, we've had quite a few of the Excel teams on today. And what we've asked them, you know, have you found, by being an Excel team, do you find there's a lot of pressure to win every game? You know, how's it going?
I don't think we've got the pressure. But the programme's brilliant, we're really enjoying it. We're getting the facilities down at Haxby Road, absolutely top notch this year. It's great to see us them. And we're also getting the gym session, your fitness sessions, which probably benefited a lot during games, which is showing that obviously from our results.
All sounds good. Yeah. So in terms of, I don't know, the team, who do you think is the biggest showboater, who loves themselves the most?
Who's got the greatest crack?
Yeah, he's good crack.
Well, there's Stephen Batty.
He has got good crack.
He has,
yeah,
hasn't he?
For a little guy. And the biggest show, who loves himself the most, though? Is that Batty or?
No, that's got to be Ben Thompson.
Ben Thompson.
I think we'll have to get him on at some point, won't we?
Is he pretty?
Not very, but he thinks he is.
Not very, but he thinks he is. Right, so just one more question from Jack, I believe.
Yeah, so I believe I've got Carl Swales on my... Yeah. Okay, Carl, yeah, of course I can ask that. So Carl is wondering whether you're going to finish your degree, Sam.
Yes, I am.
Fact. You heard it here first. Sam Rowe will finish his degree.
So as we know, it's Christmas, Sam. You a Christmas fan?
Yeah, I don't mind Christmas. Family time.
You don't mind it?
Yeah. Don't mind.
Like summer more.
Mm. You like summer. Okay, that's a fair comment.
But you're ginger.
I just love the sun.
Doesn't love you.
So, we're done with all teams. You've got all the Christmas teams at present. And so, we've got a lovely little smiley face here for you. So, where would you like it, Sammy boy?
Strong lad.
Good peck.
Yeah, we're going to lead into the rugby union results. So, thank you very much, Sam Rowe. Have a nice Christmas. Here's rugby union. Two different stories from our rugby union sides, with the women's team settling nicely at the top of Northern 2B with an astounding win of 69-7 against Leeds Trinity, while the men's rugby union
are unfortunately not doing as well, sitting at the bottom of Northern 2B, but however they're progressing quite well in the cup and we're looking for good results from them. So here we have Yorkshire men's rugby union team. Lads, thank you very much for coming down tonight.
Pleasure.
Thank you. So straight away, you know, how's your season going? How's everything going?
We had a tough start to the season, obviously. A couple of heavy losses, you know, as the lads sort of came in and started to gel. But now, I mean, we've been training hard, been getting a lot of support from the RFU, in particular Tom Gilchrist, our coach.
Brilliant.
Getting a lot of support and getting good numbers down at training. So things have been really turning round, and we've been looking up, winning a couple of games recently. So yeah, it's things are on the up.
Fantastic. Good to hear. Good.
Cheeky winning the last cup round. So how are we feeling about the quarterfinals?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely elated to get the win in the cup against a decent Liverpool second side. And just quarterfinals now. So Newcastle thirds narrowly beat us on the 3G a couple of weeks back. We get another crack at them now up at their place. So yeah, just looking forward to it. Looking forward to getting another win.
Good. Fantastic. And Robert, if you could just talk us through your choice of hat.
Well, basically, I am the Lion King, so...
It's Simba.
I've just got this hat just to represent, like...
Oh, Pumba.
Just because I'm the Lion King, so I thought I'd wear this hat, and it's like also adds comedy value.
It's also not cool to have cold ears.
Yeah. Not gonna stay in school.
So we've been asked quite a few of the teams, and we know you two, you're quite good dancers anyway, so we thought we'd try something different. So, who do you think is the best singer in your team?
As much as it pains me to say it, it's got to be Sean Smith.
Sean Smith, without a doubt.
He's absolutely.
Is he a good singer?
He's no use for anything else. Although he's a good comedy draw for the club, to be fair.
Definitely.
But yeah, definitely Sean Smith.
So, thank you very much for Men's Rugby Union to come in and talk to us, and we wish you all the best in the rest of your season. But we do have some presents.
Yeah, it's Christmas. We were rummaging through boxes, and we found these lovely stickers. So, lads, thank you very much.
Pleasure's all mine. Right.
And before we cut to the performance from Dad, we've got a little solo dance from Toby Atkin here. He's going to do a little dance for signing Toby.
Just to show us why he's part of Rugby Union and not dance.
David Brent.
Go on, Tob.
Girls from the world, girls from the world, girls from the world.
And thanks to our dancers for that performance. We now move over to the Men's Football League table. Here we can see our men's footballers firmly in the middle of their table. We'll have to see what the next term can bring. So here we have men's football, Gad Sowerby here today. Thank you very much for coming down today, mate. Really appreciated. So straight off, how have you found the season so far? How's it going?
Yeah, we've had a fantastic start to the season. Started with a bit of a change from last year's varsity. 4 losses to 4 wins, so we were chuffed with that. Yeah. And then the season's gone really well, to be fair. The first team, the XL team, they've really started to pick up as the season's gone along. Fantastic result last week, coming 3 goals down, 10 minutes to go, and managing to get a win. That's stuff the dreams are made of, that's them, lads. Yeah, nice little away day win at Teesside, so some rivalry there. Yeah. Second team are probably benefiting as much from the XL programme. They're undefeated in the league this season. Wow. Won every single game, so they're flying. Third team have stepped up into our division after promotion last year. They're wading their way through that. They look like they can easily stay up in the division as well, which good. At the same tier of the second team, that's good for them. And then fourth team are picking up a win or two as well, so it's been a good start.
Wow. Fantastic, really good.
All in all, going quite well. So how are you finding being part of the XL programme? Are you feeling the pressure to perform?
There is some slight pressure to perform. I think the most of the pressure for us was just to turn up. So with a lax attitude we've had last year, I think everyone was looking at us, especially the short contract we've got, for it to, you know, perform. And I think the lads have, to be fair. Good. There's no question that the commitment's there, and it's a whole new attitude with the team. We've taken it on with the conditioning lads and Darren, the manager, as well, and results have started to come now. The fitness is there, and we're sort of really seeing it, like going to Teesside last week, 10 minutes to go, 4-1 down. Mm. You're sort of out the game, but you know, it's them extra sessions till 9:30 on a Monday night that, you know, means they were flagging, and it was us that were able to go on and get 4 late goals.
Brilliant, absolutely fantastic.
Yeah.
So a question we've been asked all teams. So in your team, who's the player after the game, straight off, trousers straight off, everything? Who's the one who starts
top naked man?
All time, always naked.
Yeah.
Is it you, Gaz?
It's not me. There's two lads, and I think everyone will probably know why it's him. It's Joe Wharton and Angus Jones.
It's always Joe Wharton.
Yeah.
Angus likes to parade himself around, and Joe, just any opportunity to get naked and have a laugh, he's there.
Anyway,
I like that from time to time.
Yes. We did bring you a present.
As it's Christmas.
As it's really? Christmas, yeah. So if you could just indicate on what part of your body you'd like to receive your Christmas present.
I'll take it on my arm.
Take it on the arm.
Bizarre.
It's wonderful.
Bizarre.
Yeah, it's lovely.
We'll take it on the arm. So.
Fantastic, thank you.
So, thank you again, guys, for coming along and giving us your view on the season so far. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And I think all the best from us going into 2015.
Bring it on,
eh? Yeah. So, moving on, we're going to be looking at the rest of the results from the 10th of December.
And here we have our last interview with the rowing team. Guys, thank you very much for coming.
Hi, Jack.
How are you doing? You all right? Fantastic. So, first off, straight away, how's your season going? You know, how's the retention been with the cohort, you know, getting more rowers into it? Because it's quite a hard sport.
Yeah,
it's hard.
So, yeah, we've had good numbers. We've had more numbers in this year than we have for the entire 3 years I've been here, and from last year for you. How many girls came down?
We've got about 40 girls now, including like freshers and seniors. So, yeah, that's really, really good.
At about 20 lads, which is tremendous, like, really good numbers. I did not expect this at the beginning of the year.
Brilliant.
We said we were happy with 10, so we're slightly overhand. But no, it's good fun.
Indoor competition recently, how did that go?
Yeah,
very good. We had 10 of the, in the fresher heat, we had 10 girls in the top 25. In the senior heat, we had 2 girls in the top 25. So that was really, really good. That was a really good attendance, really hard work as well.
So wow, that's the sort of level we're getting to.
That is incredible, isn't it?
Yeah.
Absolutely incredible. You know, thank you very much, you. Sorry about everything. But the one thing that we've been asking a lot of the teams is some funny questions like, so in your team, you know, who would you say, probably out of you two, who do you think's the best dancer?
You, by far. I can't dance.
You think? No, I think it's a move now?
No, definitely.
Go on. Come on. You know you want to. Go on. Give us a sprinkler. Go on. Go on.
Such a bad spot.
Go on. Go on, Charlie. You can do the sprinkler, can't you?
I have no idea what we're talking about. I'm too old.
The sprinkler. We've got the lawnmower.
I think if you're over a certain height, you're just not able to dance. Like the laws of physics don't allow it.
Motor skills.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Like coordination is just dire at that stage.
I have that problem.
Rob's speciality is the slow dance.
No.
Go on then, Rob. Show us the slow dance. Come on.
Charlie's that slow dance.
Come on. Let's have a.
This is normally when you're drunk. Oh, you have a small.
So Charlie,
awkward, definitely
no,
not aroused.
No, that's a shame. So guys, thank you very much for coming down today for the interview. It was great fun. Great to have you down. Have a fantastic Christmas and enjoy it. And we'll see you in the new year, won't we?
Yeah.
Be brilliant.
And I think now we're going to take a look at what cheerleading have been achieving over the last couple of weeks. So let's have a look at what they're doing. So, it's been a great show.
I've really enjoyed it. Have you enjoyed it?
Yeah, it's been nice.
Good stuff.
So, a big thank you to all the captains and people who took part in our interviews for today. So far, BUCS has gone brilliantly. Mm-hmm. Couldn't wish any better, to be honest. And wishing all sports teams the greatest of success going into 2015.
Looking fun, isn't it? I'm looking forward to it. So as we know, Christmas is a great time of the year for many of us. I love Christmas. Do you love Christmas, Charlie?
I love Christmas.
Big fan. But for many people, it can be quite a hard time of year. So we just, in light of recent events, we just want to say a big hand to Phil Hughes' family, who recently lost his life tragically at cricket. So here from everyone at YSJ Sport and all YSJ students, we'd just like to hand out there.
Yeah, wish you luck at this difficult time of year and moving on into 2015. So, as we all know and we can see, sport brings families together and it looks after people. So, if you are interested at any point in joining a sports team or society, we are always welcome at the SU to come and have a chat with myself, Jack, or any of the sports development team, and we will basically try and get you involved as best we can. There's never, ever a bad time to start, whether you're in your first to third year. It could be the best 4 months of your life or it could be the best 3 years. So, come and see us in the SU. We're more than happy to help. And from us, Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
Happy New Year.
I'm Jack.
I'm Charlie.
And this is YSJ Sport.
Sorry I'm late. Due to precipitation, we're not on the roof this week. However, the book season still continues at YSJ.
Don't do outtakes.
Due to precipitation, we're not on the roof this week.
For the title of Clash of the Minsters, Woody. Woody.
It's been a queen.
And welcome to this week's edition of the Sports Round. So, Wednesday the...
Sports Round.
Yeah, well, should we go Sports Round? Oh, bloody hell.
Way soon as well, and we'll be back next week with all your latest sports results at YSJ. Oh, no. God, Woody, you're so demanding.
And here are next week's home fixtures. Do that again.
Hi.
Make sure you come and support your team. And I've totally forgot what next week is.
And next week's mixed down. So the Wednesday 5th of November saw the YSJ Sport. Sorry, I'm.
And next week's fixtures follow. Next week's fixtures are as follows. Oh, bugger. First competition of this. Good luck to YSJ Sharks.
This weekend, last weekend. Oh, and we'll get their results. Oh, all the latest sports results from YSJ Sport. Oh dear.
This is so cringy.
What should we say?
How do you exchange your.
Whenever
you're ready.
I hate this, I can't do this.
Oh, was that all you were doing?
Can you colour this tash out on the actual thing? No. Hello and welcome to this week's show, week commencing the 10th of December. Hello, Yorkshire.
Next week's fixtures are as follow. Women's Rugby Union. Women's Rugby Union won at home against Hull first. Up at York St John University Sports Park.
Sorry, it's been a really good week.
We hope it has.
The autumn's closely coming in, and it's...
the autumn... Sam Rowe, I'm not entirely sure what your position is.
Vice-captain.
Vice-captain of Rugby League. Do you want to start that again? I meant what position I'm committing.
Oh, you idiot!
Don't know that.
We just went position.
Ready? Is the season going so far?
Grr.
Yeah.
Welcome to YSJ Sports. Is that it?